Hi everyone, this is Mariana. Welcome to your WOW Wrap. Let us pray this week that our Lord will give us eyes to see ourselves and others the way He sees us. This will help us understand our identity, purpose, and calling. Then, even when we go through trials or seasons of waiting, we will not become weary, confused, or shaken. We will hold on to God, knowing in our hearts that He will heal, keep, and guide us. Let us continue to draw closer to God, allowing Him to fill us with His truth, His love, and His Spirit. Our scripture for today is from Habakkuk 3, verse 17 to 18. Here is Tracy.
Though the fig tree may not blossom, nor fruit be on the vines, though the labor of the olive may fail, and the fields yield no food, though the flock may be cut off from the fold, and there be no herd in the stalls, yet I will rejoice in the Lord, and I will joy in the God of my salvation.
So let us be determined this week to find our hope in God. We live in uncertain times. Perhaps you feel as if you are wandering in a wasteland, but we have a choice. Will we choose to be shaken, moaning and complaining, feeling down all the time? Or will we look to God and hide ourselves in Him, in His loving, trustworthy and caring arms? You may wonder how and where we find hope and rejoice in times like this. Let's proclaim today, our hope and salvation are found in the Lord, the Maker of heaven and earth. We will rejoice in the faithfulness of our Heavenly Father. And let's be determined to find our identity and calling in Christ. If you look in the mirror, what do you see? A mirror doesn't only reflect our outward appearance, but tells us so much about what is going on in our minds and hearts. We so often see externally based on what we believe internally. May we allow God to transform us according to His perfect will for each of us. May we ask God to fill us with His Spirit, with His truth, and with His love, so that we will be ready to go where He calls us, sowing the love of Christ into the lives of those around us. And next time, when we look at ourselves in the mirror, may we see what Jesus sees. Let's remember that what we think about ourselves, the foundation of our identity, is a significant hinge in our relationship with God. So let us remember this week, we have hope because Jesus gave all of Himself to us. This was unconditional love, even to the point of death. If we truly understand this type of love, we would look at our lives and the lives of those around us very differently. God is choosing us. God is calling us. God is loving on us. Regardless of our circumstances, regardless of the desert we may be finding ourselves in, He is faithful. God's promises are true. They are yes and amen in Christ. We do not have to be afraid because He is always with us. We can rejoice, receive His peace, and have hope. May we go out and may our lights shine so brightly that our lives will point others to Jesus. Now, let us stand united as we pray together.
Father, I ask God that this wasteland would not be wasted, that our sojourn in this wasteland would not be wasted, but that we would allow ourselves to be fed by You, to be nurtured by You, that we would meet You in the middle of the confusion, in the middle of the distress, in the middle of the financial difficulties, that we would meet You here and we would allow ourselves to be led and fed by You.
Abba Father, what if the oil is the souls of the lost, then we are at a very critical time in history, because I think never ever before has there been so many lost people, people needing you, and we need to go out and love them with your love. Help us open the doors, open, give us venues through which we can work, bringing your love to a broken world. Help us to fill our lamps with truth, with your Holy Spirit, with intimacy, but above all else, love.
Our Heavenly Father, we come to you in the precious, wonderful, loving, beautiful, powerful, mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, first of all, Lord, that you gave your Son that you loved so much for us because you love us. And Lord, we ask you to help us hold on to that love, that one promise that you love us unconditionally, that your grace is there for us and it's sufficient for us. And even if we don't feel strong, that your grace is there. Thank you, Lord, for your mercy. Thank you for forgiveness. Thank you that you love us, Lord. But thank you so much that you made us in your image. We thank you, Lord, that you chose each of us.
Father God, we thank you so much that you are a God we can trust. You are a Father that keeps his promises, and you let us know what your promises are. Father, as we go through our dark nights of the soul, let us focus on you. Let us remember those things that you have already fulfilled in our lives and in the lives of those around us and those we love, so that we can trust that you do keep your promises and we can know that it is going to be yea and amen. Father, we ask that you continue to give us those dreams and those visions and help us to focus day by day, step by step, on what you want us to do while we wait for the appointed time that you have for these things to come to pass. Thank you, Jesus. And I ask that you bless each one of these dear, dear sisters and brothers. And Lord, I ask that you strengthen their faith through whatever is going on in their lives. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus, that you loved us first. And God, my ask is that you would galvanize and write onto our hearts this purpose, this calling, this challenge. You have given and imparted something of wisdom to each and every one of them. And I pray that in that wisdom, they will be able to walk out your mandate, walk out the purpose, walk out the calling in the midst of the suffering, in the midst of the pain, in the midst of the loss, in the midst of the dread, that they'd walk it out and that they'd have a revelation of you, Lord, revelation of a risen Christ. Ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Keep safe, be blessed, and have the most wonderful week.